My presentation is divided in two parts. In first part, there are three chapters about importance of personal plan, about the development of it, and about the most essential steps we have to make. In the second part, I will present two types of methodologies. In first, personal plan guidance, I will present the methodology of assessment and prepare the personal plan. And in the second, it's client personal card, where it's some kind of self-assessment method where clients prepare the data by themselves. You will see in the next slides what I mean. So about the goal, I already speak, and more details I will explain in next chapters. A personal development plan is important because with this we provide client support management, and we also create interactive process between each other. It is very important that we take on a holistic and researches oriented view on clients' problems and needs. For work with the Roma people, the trainers, practitioners have to have special knowledge, skills, and competencies. When we are speaking about the knowledge, it is important that the person have to prepare personal plan guideline. It is important that have to know work with networks, that know family systems, is experienced in on education field, especially know all vocational fields. The next knowledge, which is very important, is that the trainer know characteristics and problems of Roma people and all relevant laws connected with their education and also employment. The next important issue is that he knows conditions of the local and regional labor market and requirements of certain vocational paths. About the skills this person, this mentor or trainer, we can call him on different ways in different countries, have to have is that they must have skills to create support plan alone or in collaboration with some other experts. They have to collect and reflect the client's resources, listen actively, and ask very important questions to him or to them. They must take the clients seriously. They must be curious, open-minded regarding to the client, and be result-oriented and make decisions. And the aims which will be expressed should be smart. Smart means that must be specific, measurable, attractive, realistic, and terminated. And if you go to competencies, they must have. They must have competencies to implement measures of biographical work, reflect clients' own action, handle stress in order to keep health and solve these strange situations, cooperate with the client and all other participants in an appropriate manner. They have to develop situation, solution strategies in cooperation with the client and his supporting system. And they must empathize with the client. So these were the knowledge competencies and the skills the trainers have to work with the Roma people to prepare good personal plan. And the most important steps at preparing personal plan are here. There are six. First is anamnesis, second assessment, support plan, monitoring, process balance, and follow-up care. I will explain in two, three sentences each other, because this is a very important part of this methodology, which is called guidelines for preparing personal plan. Anamnesis is first introducing conversation with client and trainer, and it's some kind of biographical counseling interview. It is important that atmosphere at this interview is comfortable and nice, because this is first impression client will get. And this is first step to the defined mandate and to decide if the tool is appropriate for client. The next step is assessment. This assessment depends on mandate from first phase, first step, and handle different approaches. We have to handle different approaches to know the client and find out his or her formal competencies and empower them. The third step is support plan. Preparing support plan means implementation, preparing common agreements between client and trainer, and of course always with cooperation with the clients. Relevant sources we have to choose and support the client. And in this phase or step is we have to overview the process of support. Support targets should be SMART. I already said that: specific, measurable, attractive, realistic, and terminated. The next step is monitoring. This means control and survive the support process as a whole, reevaluation the client situation, updating the assistance and change plan if necessary, setting new goals and modification the approach on basis of previous experiences together with client. The next step is process balance. This is extended evaluation. Assistance plans, assessment has to be conducted at the end. Sub-goals, fallbacks, failures have to be assessed. Plan the ending and of support process or subsequent assistance and final conversation with the client. And then comes the last step, follow-up care, which contains meetings between the trainer, practitioner, and the client after a couple of weeks to check if everything is okay and if solutions are still the right ones. Now I will introduce these two tools, personal plan guidance and client's personal cards, or we can call also methodologies, which are important to prepare the personal plan. Personal plan guidance provides guidance and support for Roma people in making the personal plan. We create interactive process of evaluation, where the person itself has an equal possibility to participate. There are certain steps, which I already presented you, and standard procedure and evaluation included. We deliver the general assessment and evaluation of the person and coordinate between participants and other involved parties or participants. It is important that we take holistic and researchist-oriented view of the people, of the Roma persons and their needs. We have to work with representatives of educational system and provide the best possible cooperation and coordination between all people involved in the process preparing this personal plan. And we serve also as a central contact for all parties involved. We have to ensure and help with realization of personal plan. Which results contains this kind of methodology? At the end, when all these steps are made, we get certain results, and the results are listed here. In this PowerPoint presentation, I didn't present you this tool as a whole, but if we have time, I can do it afterwards, after the all presentations, because you can much easier imagine what I mean with this tool. For instance, that I only present this in PowerPoint. We get employment problem assessments on a situation on assessment scale of these people we are working with. We get degree of vocational program, educational abilities and functioning, summary of relevant social and environment factors, support and social network, level of active education seeking, level of limitations and possible possibilities to help, needs for environment adaptation, level of independence and training and education, and formal and informal competencies. Selected field and type of education, formal or non-formal. Now we come to second tool. We want to present you, this is client's personal card. Client's personal card, and as I said at the beginning, is self-evaluation tool. This tool gives the most important personal information about themselves. Somehow this is formal identity of themselves. With this tool we create a positive picture about the person and raise their own self-awareness. We make formal and informal competencies visual. We get a register of all clients' competencies and interests, and we help to organize the client's strengths and plan the occupational and personal orientation. These are the parts of personal card. They are designed as a portfolio, and the four main elements are my interests, my competencies, my aims and next steps, and my application documents, which are attached to the personal card. The personal card aims to create a positive picture of the person's life and expectations. It's practical and demonstrative, and serves as a documentation tool for respective young person, other person and other persons during the application process or both. It induces self-awareness and reflectivity. So after personal plan is created, the task of trainer is to provide guidance and assistance in the realization of personal plan and to help to overcome obstacles and difficulties that might occur. So counseling, encouraging and motivation in active role of the Roma participants, this is what we get from this personal plan, learning about possibilities of participating in education and training, assistance in choosing appropriate vocational goals, and help to step from educational to vocational field after finishing selective education, developing of social skill, follow-up and professional support of education, and provide support for learning and education. This will be all from my side. If you have any questions, I'm prepared to answer to you.
Okay. Thank you, Zdeněk, for the presentation. Now it is possible for the colleagues to ask some questions. I'm going to change the meeting into an not a listen-only meeting, but a Q&A mode. So it is possible to unmute yourself and ask your question. So just give me one second.
All attendees are muted and may unmute themselves by pressing *6.
Okay, if somebody has a question, you can ask it in the chat room and then I will give you the floor. Or you can use the interact button to raise your hand so I can give you the microphone and you can ask your question.
Question. Yeah, you can ask questions. I see that.
Hello, Zdenka. Is that?
Yes. Hello.
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 Thank you for your presentation. I really admire the way your approach and methodology, considering this personal questionnaires and the personal data actually you are developing. Can you considering that you have been working there for a number of years, as far as I know, something about the numbers per year. So what are the challenges here? So do you have some data on the numbers of the Roma or the people that you are actually working with in this regard?
Yes, thank you, Stanka. Have to say that we develop this. Do you hear me? Yes. We develop this tool with a combination of one European project when we want to assess and we want to prepare personal plan for youngs with learning difficulties, which have also difficulties on employment access. And that's why we use this tool, which now I rebuilt for Roma people. So I add some more data and put out those which are not necessary or not relevant. So in numbers, I cannot say exact numbers, but with this project, which was finished, we evaluated each partner 50 persons. But then after the project finished, this is now 2 years, 3 years after the project, we are using for our disabled persons. We are still using this tool, but I don't have the data how much they use this field, our psychologists, because this is not this is not, how can I say, collecting this information, because they're using many other tools too. Did you hear me?
Yes, thank you. Okay. That's quite okay. I guess you have the capacity also to, I mean, in terms of the number of people providing this service in your institution on annual basis.
Well, we have data how many people we assess in yes. general. In general, we 800 disabled persons per year, but not all have the same assessment.
Yes.
Not all. Some stays 1 week, some stays 1 month, some three months, some 6 months is the maximum. But the type of assessment which they get, there is some general assessment which is obligated by the law, but this is special one. This is when we wanted to have more data, and we're not always using this one, only for the person which we find out that will be good to have this mm-hmm. data for the other actions.
Thank you.
Thank you.